Good afternoon, Madam Chair.
Good afternoon, sir. ASEC, may ideya po ba ang DILG kung saan-saan sa Pilipinas nakalocate yung mga miyembro ng KOJC?
Well, as far as primary information is concerned, we always leave that to the PNP, Madam Chair.
And ano po yung mga plano ng department para tulungan yung mga victim survivors?
Well, even during the, well, under the watch of Secretary Abalos and now under the new secretary, the newly minted secretary, Secretary John Big Rimulya, now the department always believes in a whole of government approach, now vis-a-vis this problem. And the primary participation of the department will lie on looking into the possibility of involvement of our local government officials, particularly those with whom the department acquires direct authority. Now, in line with the delegated power of general supervision cascaded by the president in favor of the DILG secretary. So what we're doing here right now is we're trying to identify local government officials in the local level now who had been found remiss in addressing basic deliverables and duties under the law, then probably move forward and proceed with potential case build-up, and then eventually the last stop would be the filing of cases. Now, all of these endeavors are being done in closed coordination with the PMP, of course, with the DOJ, now with the other stakeholders in the government. But again, Mr. Chair, with your indulgence, I would like to go back to the initial episodes of this hearing wherein we always emphasize, you know, through this representation, the inadequacy of the department in so far as disciplining our local government officials are concerned. Now, we are basically bereft of any authority to directly discipline our local government official. So that is a, quote and unquote, a mischief, probably, now, for which we are being faulted. And we have been trying to now move our best put forward to call the attention of our legislators in particular to probably introduce amendments to the local government code and somehow put flesh and blood and possibly muscle into the authority of the department to discipline our local government officials, not only in the case of trafficking, no, mendicancy and abuses being perpetrated on the minor children that we have, but even the many transgressions being perpetrated by local government officials. If you will remember, Madam Chair, under the same committee, the case of Mayor Guo, in particular, if I can mention that instance, now the many travesties being committed by local government officials, of which the only possibility that we can do is proceed with the case build-up and eventually file the case in the proper forum. Probably now the perspective would have been much more better and probably proactive if the department will have a direct involvement in disciplining our local government officials, Madam Chair.
Maraming salamat para doon, ASEC Benitez, and the committee will really appreciate and i-share po namin sa Senate Committee on Local Governments kung meron pong proposed formulation ang department. Paano nga po mapaganda yung local government code in this aspect? And if I could just follow up one specific point na itanong ko rin kay Colonel Likud kanina, in terms of yung ginagawa ng department looking into the involvement of local government officials, meron po bang investigation ngayon or fact-finding kung yung local government sa Davao City ay nagprotekta sa anumang illegal activities ni Kibuloy or ng KOJC or ng Angels of Death for that matter?
No, yes, Madam Chair, that is already included in our menu, but at this point in time, we have been prioritizing our fact-finding inquiries. Now, considering the lack of manpower that the department has at the moment, but inarguably that is within our table, and probably after we are done with the POGO issues, because the POGO issues has been or had been ramifying from one now area into another, then probably we can set our attention and our energy to the Davao now controversy insofar as this KOGC matters are concerned, Madam Chair. Maraming salamat po.
Maraming salamat din, ASEC Benitez, at sa pagtsatsaga talaga ng department sa pagsubaybay sa mga issue na iniimbestiga din po namin sa Senado, mula POGOs hanggang itong human trafficking Kibuloy and KOJC. Lastly po, Asik Benitez, may investigasyon... Okay, naitanong na rin po ito kanina. Maraming salamat po, Asik Benitez. Sa Dole naman po, sino yung nandito para sa Dole? Meron po ba? Wala ba, Comsec? All right. So the committee will just write the department, yung mga labor and employment questions. Para po sa DOJ and specifically DOJ IAKAT, will it be... sino pong magsasalita for DOJ? Senior State Counsel Quintana. Yes, ma'am. Pwede nyo po ba kaming bigyan ng progress update dun sa mga kaso na nakahain na kay Apollo Kibuloy? If there's anything to add from what was earlier discussed. Yes. Oh, maybe. Yes, so it will be Deputy State Prosecutor Torrevillas. Yes, ma'am.
I cannot discuss the merits of the four cases pending before the Quezon City Court.
And Attorney, I'm so sorry. Hindi pa ba kayo nakapagsumpa kanina? Hindi pa po. So may I ask you to? Sorry at this point. Special. Comsec Paki po.
Kindly raise your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in this Senate inquiry proceedings?
Yes, I do.
Yes, Senator. She answered affirmatively.
Salamat, Comsec, at salamat, Deputy State Prosecutor Torrevillas. Yes po, you have the floor on progress update sa mga kaso na inihain kay Kibuloy.
We have the pretrial conference on October 22, both in Regional Trial Court in Quezon City and in Pasig.
Salamat po, Deputy State Prosecutor. And yung susunod na tanong, kasi ay napag-usapan na rin po ninyo kanina kay Majority Leader Tolentino, so yung update sa extradition request ng US government. So salamat para sa muli sa naunang update dyan. Matanong po si Yusek Tapales ng Council for the Welfare of Children. So ito, pa-ways forward na po tayo, ano ang ating gagawin? Ano po yung sinasabi ng naging buong episode na ito sa estado ng mga batas natin para sa mga bata?
Magandang hapon po sa lahat, sa makabatang hapon po mula sa Council for the Welfare of Children. Kagalang-galang na taga-pangulo, of course na natutuwa ho kami na napakayaman po ng information, kumbaga treasure trove of information po ang narinig natin po ngayon, ano. Pero siguro just to set to give some context, our present laws already address most if not all of the matters addressed today, particularly as early as 1974, PD 603 in section 59 already prohibits improperly exploiting children, using them in begging and other acts inimical to their interest and welfare. That's section 59 item 7, and section 59 item 8, it already inflicts prohibits the infliction or inflicting cruel and unusual punishment on children and the deliberate subjecting of children to indignities or excessive chastisement. This particular provision was originally confined to parents, itong section 59 po ng PD 603, but with the enactment of Republic Act 7610 in 1992, in section 10 of Republic Act 7610, this was made to apply to any person who will commit any of the acts enumerated in Article 59 of PD 603. So pinaparusahan na po ito ng ating batas. At of course, we have three trafficking laws already, starting with the 2003 original Trafficking in Persons Act, the 2012 version, and the 2022 amendment. And of course, we leave it to the Philippine National Police and the DOJ on the characterization of the proper offense and of course, the prosecution, if so warranted, Madam Chair. But as our ways forward, listening to the discussions and the comments of everybody here, perhaps focusing now on the preventive side, because we have been discussing from the reporting, the rescue, from the prosecution, and to the eventual rehabilitation. Perhaps for the Council of for the Council for the Welfare of Children, because we are currently working with LGUs to standardize or to craft a standardized child protection policy, so the children interacting with LGUs will of course be protected at any times and free or safe from harm from the members of the LGUs themselves and even visitors and other guests of the LGUs. Marami pong mga sitwasyon dyan sa simpleng lulunsad po, kunyari, ng mga programa ng mga LGUs natin. May mga kasamang bata, nagtatransport ng bata, natutulog ang bata kasama ng mga adults. Yan po ay ilalatag po ng Council for the Welfare of Children at ipopropose po natin yan sa mga local government units, which of course will be measured in the during the execution and implementation of that child-friendly local governance audit. Ano? Ang wala pa po tayo, Madam Chair, at ito po idadagdag natin, is a standardized child protection policy for the private sector. Of course, we have a child protection policy for the schools. The DepEd released their child protection policy, I think, as early as 2012. I think they're one of the earliest, if not the earliest. But with respect to the private sector, like businesses, enterprises, offices, and even in church and religious settings, I'm not sure, I am not aware of any standardized child protection policy or any law, rule, or regulation requiring them to have such a document to, of course, ensure the protection of children while in their care or while belonging to such religion or denomination, or even protecting them from the members or even guests of these religions or denominations. So perhaps as a subject of future legislation, maybe we can look into a proposed legislation, perhaps recommending the adoption of child protection policies in the private sector, in the schools, in church settings, and even local government units. And of course, perhaps delegating the responsibility of monitoring and evaluating the implementation of child protection policies into a sturdy and strong agency, of course, like the Council for the Welfare of Children, and even perhaps a Philippine Commission on Children moving forward, Madam Chair. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you also, Yusek Tapales. So it's beginning to sound like another example tulad nung binanggit din kanina ni, I think it was General Torre, yung whole of nation approach. So nagpa-partner na kayo sa LGUs, and then syempre from the get-go with the NGOs, no, civil society, nagpa-partner kayo sa LGUs, nagpo-push kayo ng child protection policy, nagpo-propose ng para sa private sector din, and then iba't ibang institusyon natin from schools, faith communities, at iba pa. So salamat para doon. Lastly po, baka meron kayong gustong idagdag. Ano yung agenda ng Council of the Welfare for Children sa mga child victim survivors ng human trafficking?
Madam Chair, perhaps the most tangible contribution of the Council for the Welfare of Children insofar as violence against children is concerned, the CWC being a policy-making agency is of course the Makabata Helpline 1383, which is being positioned as the main or focal or apex helpline of our government for all children's concerns, of course, covering violence against children, including sexual abuse, whether offline or online. We are in the process of having the Office of the President or the President sign an executive order institutionalizing the Makabata program, which will institutionalize and harmonize all the programs of our government relating to children in need of special protection, which includes children subjected to or victims of violence. And this will standardize the efforts of all of the government from reporting, rescue relief, rehabilitation, and reintegration. And this executive order, hopefully when signed, will also institutionalize the Makabata Helpline 1383 as the main reporting mechanism of our government for children. And of course, for the National Children's Month, Madam Chair, we are focusing on child protection and child participation. As the PNP may know, based on the data of the PNP Women and Children Protection Center, for 2023, Madam Chair, they received a total of 18,756 reports of child rights violation, 17,304 of which constitute child abuse, rape, and acts of lasciviousness of children. So the spate of violence against children is still high in our country. That's why we are actively working, of course, with the PNP and the Department of Justice and other national government agencies, and of course our private sector partners and our legislative champions to really make a dent on the high incidence of VAC in our country, Madam Chair.